he was standing 45 degrees to this line. He had a small like twist in his lips when he presented that statement. He had this innocent action, and she had this again a negligible reaction, not so big reaction. She presented it very lightly. Do you think Dhananjaya first captured it on the paper, then checked this body language will suit this sentence, then thought this husky voice will be suitable for this? All of them were planned together. Like, at this point, I need to bring down my voice and have a sentence in a husky voice. At this point, I have stood this way for a long time, let me change my direction. And at this point, this element will work out as a good joke. I have talked about my employer, I have talked about my father, let me bring my wife into this picture here. So, everything came together and he drafted this sentence for this body language, for this voice modulation. So, it's not a script, then body language, then voice modulation, it's all put together at the same time. Like, for one line of your preparation, they say it takes 1 hour of, I mean, for one line of your script, it takes 1 hour of your preparation time. So, when you have that ample time spent on your preparation, the script finally sounds so good. And we talked about how the structure can be, we talked about how the preparation shall be. Now, one final word on the rehearsals, right? How do you rehearse your script? In most cases, we feel bored on the fourth day of our rehearsals, right? Yes? Okay. That's simply because, like, UGB fun, what is that? Karate Kid? Karate Kid? The boy, I mean, Jackie Chan says this to the boy, UGB fun is too much of something, is good for nothing. Like, when you practice something so many times, you become mechanical. Again, the way the joke doesn't work when you doubt the audience, when you doubt the quality of the joke. Now, what happens usually is, we all have a room, am I right, wherein we practice our speeches. And we always stand against this wall and present our speech. Yes, we do that?
Yes, yes.
Okay, we are not comfortable going to another room, facing another wall. Am I right, psychologically?
Yes.
Or are there people here who practice it at different places?
Yes.
Fantastic. Those people will not feel bored of the rehearsals, if I were right. The only problem is, like, how many of you thought I looked at you in your eye now, in the last 20-25 minutes? How many of you felt that I looked at you? Okay, brilliant. It's highly impossible for a speaker to look at everyone in this audience in a 20-25 minute span. But almost every one of you raised your hand. Actually, it was an illusion. I did not look at you. I did not look at most of you who raised your hands. You are only a picture to me. Do you agree?
Yeah.
You are only a picture to me. I just glance this way, you feel that I looked at you. And when you practice your speech, you have one such image in front of you. The wall at your house. And when you face this wall, present your speech, that in your brain becomes an audience. The next time you go face the same wall, your brain internally thinks you are talking to the same set of people. You come back again, you are again talking to the same set of people. You come back again, you are talking to the same set of people. Slowly, the concentration on your body language, voice modulation, clarity, all get diluted even without your notice. The fourth time you go on, you feel, I need a break, I'll go for a coffee. Now just do this thing for a change. You stood against this wall. The next time, turn this side, stand against this wall. You will tend to do something so fresh. You'll be doing it all with the same energy. Now change the room, go somewhere else. Stand in front of a different picture. You'll have the energy. And when you practice it so many times this way, definitely the club level contest, area level contest, division level contest are all going to give you different such pictures in front of you. In Toastmasters, people are not allowed to move when the speaker is on. So it's definitely a picture. Still picture. So people are going to look at it the same way. Maybe at times reactions like this, and again they go to the same way. See? Right? So always have that practice so that your brain is tuned, accustomed, and habituated to that picture in front of you. Got that? So things that I wanted to convey, friends. Quickly, let me summarize. We talked about the first 90 seconds. Let's try to insulate the core message from the title that you have given to the contest master. Everybody is listening to you the moment you entered the hall. So the 90 seconds is more important. As you move towards the content, let us ensure that it is universal. And as we move towards the conclusion, let's see that the message is highlighted. In fact, here is a quick note. I told you the first 90 seconds is very important. Everybody will have the best in the first 90 seconds. So your conclusion is not fighting with all the other contestants. It's fighting with the first 90 seconds of the next contestant. It's battling that way. Try to understand it psychologically. That's when you add more emphasis to that area. And then we talked about the preparation. Think of scripting, body language, voice modulation all together. not one after the other. And then finally, the rehearsals have different scenes in front of you, so that the preparation goes good. Whatever you do, do it with confidence. I'll give you a quick comparison on that line. Earlier, you would have heard that world championship speeches were winning speeches if they made people cry. Yes? If that was so emotional. And people have been so fast in their delivery, people have been so slow in their delivery. There have been humorous speakers winning ISC contests. Do you see the contradictions in all these points? Like, everybody has won. People of many different skills have won. Now assume you have a powerful emotional speaker here. You have a powerful humorous speaker here. You have a rapid paced man here. You have a slow paced man here. Who will win this contest? Who will win this contest? The answer to that question is the answer to every one of us.
Who is good on that day?
Can you rephrase it, sir?
Whom the judges understood best.
Whom the judges understand? Whom will the judges understand best? Because they are powerful in their own area. They will make you understand for sure.
Fourth fellow,
slow paced.
Whoever is confident on their.
Who has taken his message to the heart. In fact, you were all giving me the right answers. Maybe let me put it in this word. They all had different skills. The one who believed his skill the most wins that day. The one who felt, I as a fast-paced speaker can win the hearts. I can present it this way and still attract people. If his belief was better than the belief that the slow-paced man had that day, he becomes the winner. And that is evident. So belief, belief, belief. The confidence that you have on the script, the confidence that your jokes will work, that your message will work, matter the most. Right? So the yellow is on. With this, let me close the inputs. If I have questions to answer, I shall gladly. Yes.
Your opening humor,
yes,
for the world championship features, it helps in two things. One is it is independent of the team, like you open. And some empty speech, it leads to the team.
Correct.
If you talk about the technology, it creates the humor, leads to the team. So which is better?
Second one.
If possible, stick to the team.
Yes. In fact, you were quoting my speech, that's why I'm giving this. I started saying, I fumbled. My coach said, good afternoon ladies and gentlemen, I again did this, I talked about Diwali scene, I talked about this Caesar Brutus, they were all taking me towards failing in the first impression, right? They take you to that. The jokes, the magic tricks, so I told you this man did this and
your
said.
Your example is leading to the team.
Yeah, so well, it's correct, that's the answer. It should lead to the team, friends, it cannot stand alone. Not just insulating, but also taking you, I mean helping you with the next minute of your speech. Yes, sir.
You know, the four people, the most confident man will win. It's a little like saying in the 100 meters dash, six people, the most confident will win. Is it really so? Isn't it who is capable of doing a better job?
No.
I mean, it's good to hear that.
Yes.
But, you know, honestly.
The one who is capable of doing that? See, there are, I've seen a few sets of people, sir. When you say the person who is capable of doing that, he will have a bit of fear in him. He will have a bit of fear in him. If you would really present what he had in his mind, but that fear is definitely not on the contestants. That fear is not on the contestants. That's if he can deliver it so well. And his belief on the contestants, when he thinks about the contest, he is the man who has the belief that day. In fact, a person whom you think is highly capable of is the one who believes it the most. And when he goes onto the stage, he presents it with all the belief that he has. Maybe the other guy who is not highly capable of, after he looks at this contestant, maybe he's contestant number 4, he comes at contestant number 5, will not hold that belief. There is a trip in that. Or maybe during the talk when the contestants are seated together, he dips his belief. But this man who is capable of will have the same level of belief. In my opinion, I believe that it is that way. I will humbly go, I will take your suggestions, I will also think on that, sir. Wonderful idea.
Do you always stick to your script or have you ever tried on the spot?
No, don't do that with ISC. Definitely not. Try that with humorous speech contest. Like in humorous speech contest at the area level, I cracked a joke, people did not understand that. Later, after 2 seconds, it was something like this. My wife was angry at me. She threw the water bottle on me. I just ducked. And that is the way my wife misses me every time. I said this. After 2 seconds, people understood the joke and there were people laughing. Oh, great that you understood. I said that. They were laughing for that as well. I do that in humorous speech. Don't do that in IS. No. Maybe something works, you become over emotional, you will fail in the next sentence. Don't deviate from your path. In fact, when it comes to ISE, if you have decided that your speech should close at 6 minutes 32 seconds, close it at the same time every time. No changing on the spot. Maybe you can do that when the previous speaker is on the stage. Like the previous speaker goes there, does something, you can buy a wonderful word from it, you can buy a wonderful connect from that. Yeah, you can do that. The callback can be done, but not on the stage. You go there, suddenly you see someone walking into the room, you feel like talking about him, quoting him as an example. I believe it would disturb you. Heavily disturb you. ISE, the others are presenting what they had in the script. Others are presenting what they had rehearsed 100,000 times. You are doing something for the first time. Listen. Match, I believe. Yeah. But wonders can happen, sir. Every education session is only 359 degrees. The remaining 1 degree comes new every time there is a contest. Something new, something that people have never seen works. Let's try that once. At least notably, it's not a condition. They don't say, the grandfather said, come on son, I want you to grow up. No, I wouldn't do that. It's not an essential condition that you do this every time. But at least notably, let the audience not be given any work. They should not think, okay, who is talking now? Is it the grandfather or the son? No, that work shouldn't happen. There are people who have effectively handled this, friends. They don't change positions. They just turn their angles. Son, why don't you listen to me? No, father, I'm not going to listen to you. This is sufficient. I've not moved, but I've given a clear demarcation. Times, if you find this is being too much, maybe so conventional.
What about talking in face to face, without facing the audience, people do the conversation.
Not much.
What do you think about it?
It is recommended to be like.
Now we are talking now.
Correct. Now they are looking at me. There is a beautiful term in English, like the stage plays. There is a beautiful word for this. Like looking at each other and not looking at your desk. I forgot on that. Sorry on that. But it should be to a very limited amount of time. Very limited amount of time. Every time that you take your eyes off the audience, you are leaving them alone. You are leaving them alone. And they don't want to stay in that position for a long time. You should come back to them. Yes, come back to them. In fact, Teerajendra movie, that is how it should be. We shouldn't be turning this side. Like look at the audience every time, every time. If at all you turn this side, say one sentence, two sentences, come back. Come back, come back. Definitely come back. 45 degrees is always good. Like, in fact, all speakers, like, did you see any speaker turning this side and speak? 45 degrees. Maybe the hand can be this way. But there is a psychology which says, at any point of time, all the audience should be able to see at least 45% of your face. They should be able to see that. So, check on. That's a good thing. Like, you have a drastic change. Again, take them back in your arms. Thank you so much for the reception. Thank you. Back to the TMOD.